You're listening to the audio production of Strategic Customer Service, managing the customer experience to increase positive word of mouth, build loyalty, and maximize profits, second edition, by John A. Goodman and Scott M. Bretzman, published by HarperCollins Leadership and read by Mark Smeby. Please note that you may download an accompanying PDF that provides enhanced materials for this audiobook. To download the PDF, please visit HarperCollinsLeadership.com/strategic audio. Foreword by Chip R. Bell. There are times the stars align for a magical moment. John Goodman was already a giant in the field of customer service when we first shook hands. His landmark study on consumer complaint handling in America, commissioned by the United States Office of Consumer Affairs, revolutionized conventional wisdom about service. My business partner, the late Ron Zemke, wrote a best-selling groundbreaking book in 1990, Service America, that spotlighted Goodman's genius. I had read Ron's book about 1,000 times and knew Goodman's Copernicus-like statistics and insights by heart. We were working with a high-tech client and meeting at MIT in Boston. We had taken a break to get a bite to eat at the Marriott nearby. As we walked into the restaurant, we encountered John. He and Zemke were already mutual fans. I was expecting this Harvard MBA with a world-renowned reputation to view me as Ron's understudy or assistant. Instead, his gracious inclusion was as delightfully memorable as the content of his pioneering work. Fast forward almost 30 years, and he has invited me to pen this foreword to his newest addition to a powerful book. Strategic Customer Service, Second Edition, which John wrote with Scott Bretzman, is the kind of wise tome I wish I had read early in my career. It provides a wake-up call about how today's customers are significantly different than they were when John and I met. In fact, they are continuing to change rapidly. Today's fad is quickly becoming tomorrow's antique. The book clearly outlines the causes and catalogs its remedies. It provides deep insight that can inform effective strategy and thoughtful execution. Unlike many books of this type, it provides a plethora of pragmatic tools with countless case examples of the very best in action. The book also provides the central link between service process and an empowered can-do culture. It is like the great textbook you kept instead of selling it back to the bookstore at the end of the semester. The mere existence of this book and the requirement for a new edition is itself a metaphor of the times in which we live and work. Customer service was once viewed as solely the purview of the call center or the front line in a service organization. But times have changed. Those with a willingness to embrace service as a competitive differentiator will be the only survivors. We have countless examples of the failure of the way we have always done it strategy. Borders Books outsourced their online book business to Amazon. Seen a Borders lately? Blockbuster Video could have bought Netflix for a mere $50 million, but elected to stay with videotape rentals. Encyclopedia Britannica turned down an offer from Microsoft to put their encyclopedias online. And in 1998, Kodak sold 85% of all photo paper worldwide. Within a few short years, they were completely bankrupt. The graveyard of companies that refuse to adapt is large. AOL, Saturn, Sharper Image, Palm, Atari, General Foods, Compaq, Digital. Their leaders' words became part of the lexicon of head-in-the-sand decision-makers. Neither Redbox nor Netflix are even on our radar screen in terms of competition, said Blockbuster CEO Jim Keyes. Ken Olson, founder of Digital Equipment, said, "There is no reason anyone would want a computer in their home." A 20th Century Fox executive boasted, "Television won't be able to hold on to any marketed captures after the first 6 months. People will soon get tired of staring at a plywood box every night." Are you serving your customers pretty much like you did 10 years ago? Better wake up and reassess your entire operation. Your customers have changed and are rapidly changing. Whoa, you might be saying, "I am a manufacturer, law firm, or distributor of quarter-inch drill bits. My customers care about quality, expertise, and price. My customers don't expect me to be the Nordstrom of the industry." If that is your perspective, you are at risk of being left far behind. Even the concept of business to business is changing today. It is more like P2P, people to people. And the big differentiator is service, not product, proficiency, or price. There are two sides to service, the outcome and the experience. If your flight lands on time, in the right city, and with your luggage in tow, those are all service outcomes. Think of them as table stakes, the givens, not loyalty makers. If the flight attendant is super friendly and attentive to your needs, those are service experiences. Customers do not talk about the details of service outcomes. They tell stories instead about the details of their enjoyable experiences in getting those outcomes. But the standards for a service experience have also dramatically changed. Customers today get terrific service experiences in pockets of their life and use those experiences to judge your operation and everyone else. When the UPS or FedEx delivery person walks with a sense of urgency, customers expect the mail carrier to do likewise. When Disney theme park cast members treat guests extra special, they assume every other customer-facing person on the planet will do likewise. That means your customer experience competition is not your industry. It is anyone creating great experiences for those you serve. What has elevated customers' standards for their service experiences? First, customers today have way more choices than ever. A quick trip to the grocery store for a simple loaf of bread, and you are confronted with 16 brands and 23 varieties packaged 12 different ways. 3 decades ago, sliced bread came one way, white, produced almost exclusively by Wonder or Sunbeam. The more product choices customers have that are similar, the more they use the experience surrounding that product or outcome as their primary tool for differentiation and decision-making. Second, today's customers are much smarter buyers. The internet has not only been their source of real-time buying education, it has become a channel for instant customer assessment. Everyone has become everyone's consumer reports. It means businesses must monitor all the details, now very transparent to customers, to get early warnings on emerging glitches, impending changes, and on-the-horizon trends. It also means customers are more empowered to make buying decisions with knowledge from a host of sources, rather than relying on the reputation of a brand or the cleverness of its advertising. And the service side is a much bigger challenge. Why? Manufacturers determine the quality of the products they put into the marketplace, but customers determine the quality of the service they receive. And riding herd on what happens in the factory is a lot more predictable than getting customers to do what they are told. You may say your service grade has improved from a C to a B. Keep in mind that yesterday's B to the customer is today's C. Poor or indifferent service has become horrible service. Mediocre service has become bad service. Even the yardstick of service has changed. Your satisfaction is our number one goal. Sound familiar? Today, unless your organization is the only fish in the pond, using customer satisfaction as the yardstick of success will ultimately lead to disappointment, maybe even failure. Look up the definition of satisfactory in Webster's really big dictionary. It says, good enough to fulfill a need or requirement. It also means adequate or sufficient. Today's customers do not put adequate and value in the same sentence. Sufficient is hardly the language of loyalty. Organizations need to evoke customer feelings strong enough to make customers deaf to the siren call of competitors. Now, if you're in the product-making business, satisfaction might be okay for object quality. Most customers want their new trash compactor to only do what they expect it to do. But when it comes to a service experience, the customer's definition of what is adequate or sufficient quality quickly changes. Imagine coming back from a great experience, say your honeymoon, and someone asks you, how was your honeymoon? And you answered, I was completely satisfied. You'd probably land in the proverbial doghouse. 3/4 of customers who leave an organization for a competitor say they were satisfied or completely satisfied with the one they abandoned. One of the biggest differences between satisfied customers and loyal customers is their tolerance for error or for less than expected value. For satisfied customers, one strike, just one tiny hiccup, and they are ready to exit. The loyal customer is willing to forgive and give an organization a second chance. However, there is one very important caveat. Loyal customers do not mean forever and ever customers. Disappoint a loyal customer, and you just got strike one in the new loyalty game. What happens next will determine if you remain in the game or strike out and lose that loyal customer. It makes great service recovery and customer care at every point of contact a crucial organizational issue. It makes complaint handling a strategic decision, not just an interpersonal nicety. So, what do all those satisfaction as job number one billboards get you? At best, it is a customer willing to give you a try. When that customer walks through your door or signs a contract, the marketing and sales department can score a victory. But the more meaningful measure of success is whether that customer, having taken you for a test drive, comes back for more, and then convinces associates to do the same. When you've built that kind of loyal customer base, you have created a marketplace advantage difficult for any competitor to match. Like all valued relationships, if you take loyal customers for granted, they soon will become yours to lose. If loyal customers were ever entrenched by the allure of your brand, they will be no more. If loyal customers were ever long-suffering and tolerant of service blemishes and experience blunders, they clearly would be no longer. Today, value in the eyes of customers must be genuine, obvious, and ever-present. And loyal customers, the core of your growth, profits, and reputation, must be continually made to feel important, heard, and valued. Finally, there is the growing proliferation of technology into the service world. In the famous Ballad of John Henry, this Talcott, West Virginia steel-driven man with a hammer was pitted against the new steam-powered jackhammer in a competition to determine who was fastest at driving a steel rod into rock for dynamite to be placed and blasted, clearing the way for the railroad. John won the contest, but then died of a heart attack from the stress. The man versus machine has been debated ever since. John Henry is a metaphor for the changing role of humans in an ever-mechanized high-tech world where friendly voices are rapidly being replaced with IVRs, chatbots, and artificial intelligence, and helpful hands with a deflection towards self-service. Leaders have to get comfortable with the alphabet of technology: CRM, KMS, Enterprise Resources Planning, Internet of Things, etc. This book will provide those anxious about technology with more comfort, those enthusiastic about technology with more caution. Now that you have heard the wake-up call to align around a customer-centric strategy, you might be thinking, what do I do next? The good news is there is a blueprint for success that begins after this foreword. Customer service lends itself to heart-tugging stories and persuasive anecdotes, all great fodder for inspiration. But for strategy and practice, you need solid facts, concrete research, and ironclad logic. Strategic Customer Service, Second Edition, will align your stars to ensure you keep loyal customers, an enviable reputation, and a very healthy bottom line. Introduction. Customer Service versus Customer Experience. We love what we do. Customer service is a passion at Customer Care Measurement and Consulting, CCMC. Our careers in customer service consulting and measurement began in 1971 when Mark Grainer and I formed Technical Assistance Research Programs, TARP. Scott Bretzman joined us in 1991. After spending several years in the early 2000s moving in different directions, we are back together at CCMC, where we continue to do what we've done for the past four decades: help companies listen to their customers, be proactive and engaged, and respond effectively. We have been asked, why haven't you gone to work for a large organization as the vice president for customer service? For me, getting to know different industries, seeing what works and what doesn't, and seeing what works in one industry that can be helpful to another is a constant learning experience. We don't want to experiment with customers. We want to provide solid evidence and practices that work. In a conversation with the chief operating officer and the director of customer service for a new e-commerce startup, they stated that the company wanted to create strong customer engagement with robust education while making all interactions effortless, proactive, and inexpensive. This was a familiar formula. The customer service function handles the labor-intense customer engagement and education, and the technology folks assure effortless transactions and electronic confirmations on the web. This formula illustrates the future challenge of the customer service field. Unfortunately, separate, parallel configurations do not work. The solution is a unified service system that integrates the human interactions in customer service with a transaction technology. you need a system where customer service can see and track transactions, and the technology side is aware of all customer service interactions related to the transaction. This gives the customer a feeling of one-stop shopping. This book is aimed at understanding what has changed and what is the same in customer service since the 2009 publication of the first edition of Strategic Customer Service. Service directors must respond to the technological revolution as well as the needs of diverse customers and employees. While the first edition focused heavily on large companies serving consumers, this updated second edition.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.